everyone here, hope you guys are doing well, and imagine this scenario. You're walking down the street and suddenly you can't help but feel a bit anxious about all of the things you have to worry about. School, your friends, your family, work, other commitments, and so on and so forth. But then you try to tell someone about it, and it immediately seems like there are two schools of thought. Someone will tell you, stress is good, it's what drives us, you need it in your life as a core, fundamental part of you. And then someone else will say, I'm not so sure about that. Maybe you should take a step back, recalibrate, center yourself, rid yourself of all of the stress in the world, and then only move forward. And all of this got me thinking. It seems like that in today's day and age, stress has become a core part of everyone's life. And I think a large reason for that is because the phones and the devices and the notifications and the commitments and schedules that result from them have followed us even into our most intimate settings. So today's video is not so much about how we can escape stress, but rather control it and have it work for us rather than the other way around. I'm going to be going through some tools and resources that talk a little bit more about what stress means to us in this day and age and how we might be able to control it and use it to our benefit in becoming better human beings. First things first, let's analyze what it means to be stressed and why your perception of it really matters. Positive stress, or eustress, is the feeling that results when you view a stressful situation as an opportunity to accomplish a particular goal or task. And in the end, eustress can be very helpful in having higher levels of wholesomeness, well-being, and self-accomplishment. On the other hand, negative stress is the feeling that results when you view a stressful situation as a harmful threat that is sure to come out in a negative way. This type of stress can result in depression, anxiety, fear, and even physical ailments. So if we take a step back and circle all the way to the beginning, it's clear that stress is a big part of our lives. But what's most important is the way that we channel and perceive and react to it. And here are a couple of mindset practices that I believe can help you maintain a positive reaction and create that eustress feeling in the face of difficult obstacles. The first tip that I would have is to invest in a mindset where a baseline positive reaction is how you approach things. Now, I'm not saying that being negative is not important, right? Because sometimes a circumstance or situation might present itself and you need to be upset about things. That's not something that you should shy away from. But make sure you always circle back and pull positives out of every situation, because it's really easy to be negative. When something doesn't go your way, it's very simple to put your head down and not do anything productive as a result. But if you're constantly pulling out positives, then you can, it sort of transitions into the second point that I have, you can view things as a natural learning opportunity to become a better human being, to become smarter, more intelligent, more caring, so on and so forth. In order to illustrate my point, I will look at findings from the University of Wisconsin, in which a study tracked 29,000 people over 8 years in order to better understand the effects of stress on our health. The findings reported that people who had higher levels of stress and also said that it damaged their health had a 43% increased chance of death. On the other hand, people who reported high levels of stress but did not correlate it to any negative health effects were the least likely to die or even in general have any health issues. And the point of that study was to show you that stress is inevitable, but the effect that it has on you is far from it. In fact, stress can be good or bad, and it completely depends on how you use it. And this is why maintaining a positive eustress reaction to every difficult obstacle or circumstance that you may encounter is incredibly important. I will end today's video with three major points. One is to reframe stress as an opportunity to learn something. I get it, difficult situations are tough, that's why they are difficult, but you should make sure that at the end of the day, you always try and pull positives from it. Make it such that every circumstance or situation you encounter is a chance to learn something new and become a better person. The second piece of advice that I have is to make sure that you focus on what you can change and you forget about what you cannot. If you were to make a list of everything that you wanted to do in life and everything you wanted to accomplish, it would be infinitely long. But what's important is from that list, you'd only choose the things that you can do with your own two hands, that you can apply yourself to, and through hard work and willpower, you can accomplish. My third and final piece of advice, which is my favorite one, is to surround yourself with good people. Whenever you have a cohesive, positive environment, negative personalities will eventually weed themselves out. But most importantly, even when you are stressed and you have to deal with so many things, I can't tell you how much it meant to me to be able to fall back on good people who I could share my problems with. It's purely the reason that I'm here, and that every time I go through something difficult, I know that I'm gonna come out better, stronger, and more positive as a result. With that, I will leave you guys. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Nikhil. I make videos like this all the time. Be sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram. I'm going pretty hard on those platforms as well, so make sure you come by and say hello. But most importantly, and as always, I will see you guys in the next one.